5.5 number 40, we are going to integrate sine x over 1 plus cosine square x. And it seems that we have a few choices for u. We may let u equal to the denominator, and let me show you if it works or not. If I say u is equal to 1 plus cosine square x, and if I differentiate that, du will be derivative 1, 0, derivative of cosine square x. This requires a chain rule, bring the 2 to the front, and then the cosine x will stay the same for now. And then you multiply by the derivative of cosine x, which is negative sine. And as you can see that we do have the sine x right here that will possibly cancel with this sine x. But the cosine x is going to be a troublesome later on. So now, I'm going to use a different choice of u. So this is not the correct choice for u. I'm just going to let u equals to cosine x. Because if I differentiate this, I will end up with negative sine x dx, and then I can isolate the dx, and I will get du over negative sine x. And now let me take this integral into the u world. So I will have the integral of the sine x on the top over 1 plus, and we have cosine square x. And in the u world, cosine x is the u. So this part becomes u raised to the second power. Alright? So once again, the cosine x, it's a u part. Cosine square x means we have u to the second power, like that. And now, for the dx, it's going to be du over negative sine x. And as we can see, the sine x here and cancel with the sine x here. Alright, so this integral is good because everything is in terms of u. We don't see any more x's. And we can continue. This will be, notice that we have an equal sign, we have a negative sign here. So I'm going to bring the negative sign to the front. Negative integral of 1 over 1 plus u squared du. And now you have to think about derivative of what function will give you 1 over 1 plus u squared. And the answer to that is the inverse tangent x, or the inverse tangent u. So this integral will be negative the inverse tangent, and we're using u here, so we'll have u right here, and that's pretty much all. And now we just have to substitute back. U is equal to cosine x, so I will have negative inverse tangent, and for the u part, it's the cosine x, so let me put this back right here, and we are done. So I will, of course, add a plus c at the end. That's all.